respected Kailash Satyarthi ji, Praveen Kumar ji, and Venkat Reddy ji, and all my friends here. Thanks a lot for coming with a short notice here. I just explained about this event in the morning only, sir. So we are not sure how to run it. So thanks for coming here, all of you. And we missed most of you during the Bharat Yatra. As you know, in the September month, September 11th to October 15th, we have done an extensive Bharat from Kanyakumari to Kashmir. And it started on the September 11th from Kanyakumari. And it came to as well as Andhra Pradesh. So in Hyderabad, we hosted that event with more than 10,000 children and college students in exhibition grounds. That was an excellent event happened. And after that, there was a lot of traction on the child issues, child trafficking from the South India. Then as a follow-up to that Yatra, then we approached government of Telangana to start taking care of certain child-related commission, establishing a commission and appointing a chairman as well as a couple of directors to that to report the issues and monitoring the issues closely on quarterly basis. So part of that, government of Telangana came forward and agreed for declaring the Telangana as a child-friendly Telangana. So that declaration is going to happen tomorrow at Karimnagar. We are going to have a public meeting tomorrow at Karimnagar around 1 o'clock. It will start at 1 o'clock. It will go up to 4 o'clock. And we are doing that declaration with more than 30,000 children tomorrow at Karimnagar. So all the logistics and everything is already in place. And government of Telangana is really cooperating on that. And MP Vinod Kumar is doing the listening part for that, for declaring the child-friendly Telangana. So far we have done child-friendly, we have done so many things on the police-friendly Telangana and woman-friendly Telangana. So this is a great opportunity for us. It happened because of Satyarthi's effort, persistently talking with government of Telangana and his team also. They have done excellent job and coordinating with various departments like legal and women and child welfare ministry, and a police department to do the declaration tomorrow. So part of that, Kailash ji is in Hyderabad today. So we are traveling tomorrow morning to Karimnagar. So before that, we got this evening. So I thought to introduce all of you to him so that not only now, even after the declaration also, we need your cooperation, continuous cooperation, because you are from various walks of the life. You are representing so many institutions here. So a couple of them, institutions and private institutions. So we need full cooperation from all the departments to take it to the next level. So we want to establish a child-friendly Telangana, and it should happen very fast as compared to all other states. So that is what our motive. So sir already gave me a couple of responsibilities to me to coordinate in Andhra as well as Telangana. So I hope I am going to live up to his expectations, and I will take it to the next level. So without wasting the time, I would request Kailash Satyarthi ji to brief the audience, and then later on we can have some question and answer sessions. So I will give opportunity to everyone to have a word. Thank you.
Thank you, Rajni. And now I request Kailash ji.
Bahut dhanyavaad. हैदराबाद में और आंध्र प्रदेश में और इसके बाद तेलंगाना में मैं पिछले 30-40 सालों से आता रहा हूं, और बहुत मेरे मित्र और परिवार के लोग जैसे हैं हमारे वेंकट जी, शांता जी, विठल राव जी, तो यहां आना मेरे लिए घर में आने जैसा है, क्योंकि मैं बहुत जगह इनके घरों में भी और ऑफिसों में भी ठहरा हूँ। लेकिन पिछली जो हमारी भारत यात्रा हुई, वो भारत यात्रा जैसा अभी रजनीकांत जी ने कहा कि एक बहुत बड़ा अभियान था, और जैसे पुरानी कहानी है समुद्र मंथन की, तो हम लोग भी एक तरीके से समुद्र मंथन जैसा करते रहे। हमको बहुत सारे रत्न जेम्स मिले और रजनीकांत उनमें से एक हैं। और यात्रा में जो हमें पॉलिसी के बेनिफिट्स हुए, कई जगह बहुत चीज़ें हुई, अवेयरनेस हुई, मोबिलाइजेशन हुआ, नेटवर्किंग हुआ, मोमेंट बिल्डिंग हुआ, लेकिन उस दौरान जो और बड़ी उपलब्धि रही, मैंने कहा था रजनीकांत से पहले भी और अब फिर आप सबके सामने कह रहा हूँ कि हमारे लिए वो एक बहुत बड़े चैम की तरह, रत्न की तरह मिले और इस चीज़ को आगे बढ़ा रहे हैं, तो इसके लिए बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद। सो मैनी पीपल थिंक दैट नोबेल लॉरिएट इज समथिंग आउटस्टैंडिंग, समथिंग वेरी स्पेशल, समथिंग someone who is really very exclusive celebrity, etc., etc. So that is the change I'm also feeling in all these 3-4 years after receiving the Nobel Prize. People started considering me as a celebrity, not as an activist. At least you reminded me, and I always remind myself that I am an activist by heart. And whatever recognitions are given, that is different. That is very external. Internally, I am, yeah, that is sometimes distractions. There is a story that one day, a journalist, there are so many journalists sitting over here. So a journalist was driving in a remote area, and he noticed that there was a man standing in a field under the open sky. The hot summer. And that made the journalist curious, obviously, and he slowed down his car and stopped for a while just to see what this man is doing. And then he noticed that man was not doing anything, was looking at the sky, towards the sky and sun, and sweating badly. Journalist got down and went close to him and asked, "Sir, what are you doing?" He answered, "Don't disturb me, I'm doing very important thing." So the guy just waited. He had no option. So after 10-15 minutes, he went back to him and asked, "Sir, what are you doing? May I ask, what is that special thing?" So he answered that, "I'm waiting for a Nobel Prize." He was not looking like an agriculture scientist or something, because Nobel Prize are not given for agriculture scientists as well. It could be chemistry or physics or whatever piece. So then he asked, "Sir, how are you going to get the Nobel Prize?" So this man answered that, "I read in my childhood that those who are out standing in their fields, those who are outstanding in their fields, they can become the Nobel laureate. So I am standing out in my field. One day I can become a Nobel laureate." So we people become Nobel laureates like that. So don't consider something very special. But anyway, I am thankful to the government. In fact, this time, government of Telangana, and particularly my very dear friend and brother, Vinod Kumarji, who had invited me for a very historic thing tomorrow. We will talk more about it tomorrow. But let me tell you that over the years, people considered children in 3 different ways. One is that the children are innocent if they are poor, and if we are naive and noble, then we should help those children. So we run charity programs, we help children because children need some support from adults. So adults keep on supporting them. This is one way of thinking. And these people are normally considered nice people because they are helping poor children or needy children. So all the charity and philanthropy and all kind of things, sometimes you can also consider it as a religious work or holy work if you are helping children who are needy. The second thing about it is that if the children are vulnerable, if they cannot raise their voice, then they are easy prey for exploitation, abuse, injustices, and use them for prostitution, use them for child labor, use them for child baggery or whatever. So over the years, many institutions, you can call them organized syndicates, criminal syndicates, they emerged and grew and flourished to exploit children. Children could be exploited as child laborers because they can work long hours a day without making any noise. Or children could easily be taken to child prostitution because it's a normal notion that one can enjoy the virgin girls in prostitution or young girls. So this has been there for ages. And the third stream of our behavior towards children is that if they are our own biological children, then we do every possible thing to give them the best possible future. May it be schooling, may it be healthcare, may it be chocolate, may it be pizza, burger, may it be shoes, branded clothes, everything. So we keep on appeasing them and we feel happy about it. So we do all good and bad and consume a lot of money. We can do corruption or whatever, not for ourselves, but to make sure that our children's future are safe. But today we are talking about the third thing, fourth thing. The fourth thing is being child friendly. If we are exploiting children, if we are appeasing our own children, if we are making some charity to children, we are not going to create a healthy society. The healthy society could be created only when we feel that a child can be our friend or I can be a child's friend. A child-friendly society is different than the politics, the economy, the society we built over the centuries. A child-friendly society is futuristic society and society which is investing in the future. But investing in the future begins with investing in the present. That is also a philosophical and ideological issue that we feel that we can also learn from our children. Friendliness. If you wanted to make a friend, friendship begins with trust, mutual trust. Friendship, the basis of friendship is the mutual respect. If you don't respect each other, you cannot remain friends. If you don't learn from each other, you cannot remain friends. If you can listen to each other, you cannot become friends of anyone. So when we talk of being a friend of a child, your own child to begin with, then you have to respect a child. Loving a child is different than respecting a child. Caring for a child is different than listening to a child and behaving as friend. So that is different.
మరిన్ని ఇంట్రెస్టింగ్ వీడియోస్ కోసం మా సోషల్ పోస్ట్ ఛానల్ కు సబ్స్క్రైబ్ చేసుకోండి. ఇన్స్టెంట్ అప్డేట్స్ కోసం కింద ఉన్న బెల్ ఐకాన్ ప్రెస్ చేయండి. పదునైన విమర్శలు, లోతైన విశ్లేషణలు, అదిరిపోయే పంచ్లతో అతి తక్కువ కాలంలో అత్యంత ప్రజాదరణ పొందిన సోషల్ పోస్ట్ యాప్ ని డౌన్లోడ్ చేసుకోండి.